kicking the tobacco habit with e-cigarettes? That's right now, in motion. As of 2007, the percentage of U.S. smokers has been cut by more than half since 1955. That still leaves close to one-fifth of the U.S. population quite literally puffing their lives away. The connection to a long list of illnesses and diseases and cigarettes has played a role in getting smokers and cigarettes to part ways. Smoking cessation programs take many forms, from nicotine patches to nicotine gum, all the way to medications. But one product that is relatively new has some researchers concerned.
Cigarette smoke contains nicotine, the addictive drug, carbon monoxide, which is a clear odorless gas that replaces oxygen in your blood, and what we call tar, which is the black sticky mass of gunk and thousands of chemicals that attach to your lungs and your airways and cause lung cancer and respiratory diseases like COPD. And so it's primarily the nicotine that people smoke for, but it's the other 4,000 chemicals that cause most of the harm to health. So part of the idea of nicotine replacement therapy, like the patch or the nicotine gum, is to give the people the nicotine in a cleaner form and gradually wean them off. And we noticed that there's been a new invention, a new phenomenon called electronic cigarettes. Electronic cigarettes are shaped like a cigarette, they look like a cigarette, but you don't light them. They have a little electronic current that produces a vapor of propylene glycol, and it has nicotine in it. And so it almost completely replaces the habit and the behavior of smoking.
The e-cig removes the tar and other toxic chemicals from the situation and leaves the user with only the addictive nicotine, which the body craves. The user then has more latitude to step down from the addiction to the nicotine without suffering the effects of the other hazardous chemicals.
Very little is known about electronic cigarettes, and we wanted to find out a little bit more. We decided what better way to learn about electronic cigarettes than to interview users. So we did a survey of over 100 regular electronic cigarette users. Most of them had used them for over a year. And we asked them a series of questions to find out why they used them, how they're using them, and what kind of products they're using, to try and get a better understanding of this phenomenon.
A study found that while close to 80% of long-term users of e-cigs have completely ditched the tobacco habit, only 8% were using the most widely marketed version of cigarette-shaped e-cigs.
So the people in our study were not actually using electronic cigarettes like the ones that are mass marketed. Now, this is the most commonly used kind of electronic cigarette, but what we believe is that these kind of electronic cigarettes don't have enough battery power to put much of nicotine into the vapor. And there have been studies done in other places where they found that the nicotine delivery was low. But in our study of regular users, people who'd used electronic cigarettes for about a year, we found that 80% of them were not using these. They were using slightly larger models that seemed to have the ability to deliver a stronger battery power so that the nicotine could get into the vapor and deliver an adequate dose. And we think these are probably more effective in helping people to quit smoking, but they're not the kind of e-cigarettes that most people are using.
Until more extensive research can be done, Dr. Fold's research suggests that smokers trying to quit should rely on proven methods.
So, there's a 1-800 free telephone counseling service nationally that you can call that will give you good counseling. And we have medicines that have been proven to be safe and effective. So nicotine replacement, like the patch, the gum, the lozenge, nasal spray, inhaler, and prescription-only medicines like Chantix and bupropion, these have all been shown to be safe and effective. They'll all roughly double your chances of success.
For In Motion, I'm Kurt Parker.